All right, well, Zach, I haven't seen you in a while. It's been since July. I mean, you only spent 43 seconds in the cage, I think. So imagine you didn't come out too hurt. So what happened that we're only seeing you now?
Fight went great. I felt excellent after the fight. Didn't get touched. Went right back to the gym and then had a freak little knee injury. So actually, it was like 2 days right after my fight. I popped my knee and had to take some time off, you know, let it heal up. But I'm healed up. I'm back. I'm good to go now.
So no surgery, anything like that? Just rehab?
I had to get cleaned up.
Oh, did you?
Yep.
How frustrating is that to have a 43-second fight and then what is just a freak accident in training?
Yeah, very. With the Gunner fight, I had a pretty bad injury with my eye. So I was out for about a year, and that's what was the long, you know, layoff there. And then came back, man, had that 43-second knockout, and I felt great. And then right back in the gym, first hard day, and just some stupid freak thing. I don't even know what happened. I still don't know how I got hurt, but it just this meniscus kind of caught and popped a little bit. So had to clean it up, went on vacation, did some traveling, then got back in the gym, just healed up and got back after it.
Nice. What's the mindset like that? Because, I mean, obviously, I think you've kind of quietly gone 3-1 in the UFC. You've got a nice little record, but it seems like it's been tough for you to get that momentum going. So what's it been like for you to have these times away from the cage?
I love being – I love staying active and fighting. Whenever I first started my career, I think I had like 9 fights in 1 year. But it's nice to kind of fly under the radar a little bit, you know. So, but I'm honing my skills. I'm getting better every day. And it's one of those where I know whenever I do get to come out and perform, you know, it's a whole new me and stuff. So it's pretty exciting that, like, every time they see me, it's a whole new animal that shows up and everything, not just the same guy over and over. So I kind of enjoy it, but obviously now where I'm my skills are where I think they need to be, I'm ready to kind of hopefully be injury free and put a little run together and see what I can do with this.
So you kind of jumped in on about a month notice here, is that right?
Yeah, a little over. I mean, it's close to 6 weeks.
Had you been asking for something, or it just came up and you said, let's do it?
Yeah, I was asking for something beginning of the year, and then, they pushed it back, then offered me something like on a week notice. I'm like, I can't do that, And then kept asking, they offered me something like a couple day notice. I'm like, guys, man, like, I'm one of the biggest guys in the weight class. You can't do this to me, And finally, they called me and gave me an offer for one of the Brazil cards, and then it had quite a bit of time notice. And then the next morning, they called me and said, hey, you can take this fight instead. So let's do it. So let's get in there sooner. It was plenty of time to cut the weight, and I don't know. So I didn't want to wait much longer.
Was it something about this matchup that you like with Nicholas Dalby?
Either way, I mean, I actually never really heard of Nicholas Dalby until the matchup. So I had to look him up and everything. I love the matchup. I think it's great for me. He's a tough guy, a tough opponent. I think it'd be a pretty good war in there, but I honestly just feel like I got the veteran edge on him. I've had way too much experience in the cage with much higher class caliber guys. So I think it's going to play a huge factor in this fight. So I love the matchup. I'm very confident in my skill sets right now, so I'm ready to go.
He did come off a fight of the night last time out. Were you impressed by that effort at all? I mean, once you started researching him a little bit?
His will to win, his refusal to lose is that you have to be impressed by that, because he went out, he got handled for 2 rounds straight, and then just he refused. He came back and I don't know if it was an injury or whatever it was, but I mean, he put it on until in the third round, got a 10-8 round, and ended up getting a draw out of it. But so knowing that you have a very mentally strong guy in front of you is it's a good test and stuff, because I'm kind of known to be one of those that breaks people mentally. So when you have someone that's that strong, it should be turned out to be a really good fight. So
we mentioned the 3-1 mark in the UFC. The only loss was you traveling to Europe. So when you got the call to travel to Europe again, you agreed. Was there any hesitation? I mean, when you look back on that, was there any part of the travel, the adjustments, that was part of the factor at all?
Not at all. I felt great with the Gunner fight. Felt like I won the first round. Felt like I was won the second round. Like I said, I didn't really talk about it much. I had a really bad injury happen in that fight. Just a freak punch that landed. I didn't think it landed that hard, but it shattered my orbital really, really bad. I couldn't see at all. So it just kept getting worse and worse and worse. So I changed my game plan from what I was doing that was working to, let's try a crappy single leg. And Gunner's someone who you can't make mistakes on, and he took advantage of it, and he was a better guy that night. But you know, I feel like I was in that fight. I don't feel like he was a much better opponent than I was. So, you know, the travel, I made weight, the weight cut was fine. You know, we come out a little bit earlier to get adjusted. So, I mean, really the travel, it wasn't a big deal. You know, yeah. I feel like I've been, you know, kind of all over a lot lately. The travel's just not a big deal for me anymore. So I'm really excited to actually, with that fight, I built a lot of fan base over here in Europe. So I just wanted to kind of keep coming over here and feeding those too. So it's nice to build my name just outside of the U.S.
Nice. Yeah. I didn't know about the broken orbital either. So how early in the fight did that happen?
It was like right at the end of the first round, I think. Wow. It was just a straight punch that hit. And it was, I always describe it as, you ever take like a beer bottle and hit the top of it, the bottom broke out?
Right.
It's a back. So it hit my eye like perfectly and the back just shattered. Like it was huge. So, yeah, and I just thought I got poked in the eye. I didn't even feel the punch. You know, I just thought like you poked me and I just couldn't see. And then I almost missed the stool in the second round. And then as the second round went, like as I kind of sat and rested, it kept getting worse and worse and worse. But I don't know, I had to get surgery on it and it was a long recovery to overcome and stuff, especially, you know, and then training, getting hit again, stuff like that. But it's healed. I went in the last fight and with no worries at all. So I don't know. It's not even a thing now, but it just sucked in that fight.
Wow. So is that one you kind of want back because of kind of the way it played out?
Yeah.
You want that one again?
Yeah. Well, I don't really care about. I mean, it's one of those where I'm not begging for rematches. You know, I want to keep building, keep getting better. You know, I have this fight to take care of first, and once I get this, you know, I'd love to get a top 15 guy, and then just keep building the ranks. If I see Gunnar again, I do. If I don't, I really don't care. It's not that big of a deal to me.
Fair enough. Well, what kind of fight do you think we're going to see? I mean, as you see this thing play out in your mind, knowing what you know about Nicholas Dalby now, what do you think we see?
Man, I see a lot of stand-up going on. You know, he's a volume guy. I'm a power guy. Ultimately, I feel like once he feels my power, he's going to probably try to look and take me down and go for his last double legs. And he hasn't seen a wrestler like me. So, I could see me hitting him hard and him taking a bad shot, me stuffing it, putting him on his back, and probably finishing the fight.
You feel like this is the time now you can maybe start building that momentum?
Absolutely. Absolutely. I know it's been a little bit since the last fight, but I'm going to build right off of it. I went in the last fight not caring who they put in front of me, knowing I was going to knock the guy out, and I'm in the same mindset where I'm finishing whoever's in front of me.